and they're stepping out to the line.
Maybe for the last time.
And they're off. That's the gun. We see Amanda Eccleston out there too, and she's jumping to the front. She's doubling back from the 1500, and I think she's going to take some pacing duties. That's Ailish McColgan there in the blue on the inside. And like we said before, she ran 30.58 right here in the Brickyard 2 weeks ago. And she's looking to hopefully take this one here.
Yeah, definitely someone that you would expect to see up in the front.
She's a tall individual, as you noted.
Yeah, and I realized when I said that, I did say that commentators shouldn't talk about bodies, so I probably just shouldn't. I'm just so jealous, you know? something that I've always wanted.
It was a good-natured compliment.
But yeah, you in seventh place is my teammate, Allie Buchalski. And I just got to say that I think we can expect a pretty big race from her tonight. She is in incredible shape if her workouts say anything. So I'm really excited for her to have this opportunity to race tonight.
We've been hearing that. So we've been hearing that from the Brooks camp, from the Beast camp, that Allie is in really good shape. And she ran a time trial recently, correct?
She did. And it was a 600-meter time trial, so I don't know how indicative of 5K fitness it is. But she ran like a 93-second 600, which as a distance runner, I'm super impressed with.
That's some speed.
Yeah.
That's some very good speed for a 5,000-meter runner.
Yeah, definitely.
And we see Bailey Myers also in there, too. And she might be working with her teammate, Weini Kelati, right there behind her in fourth. And Weini Kelati had a very good result here in the Brickyard in December. She also ran a 10,000-meter in 31:10, and that was for second place in that 10,000-meter race.
Yeah.
So the Brickyard, very conducive to 10K running.
Yeah, I can see it now. These conditions out here are incredible.
Yeah, these are prime conditions. So we'll see how well the 5Ks go in the Brickyard here tonight. But Ailish McColgan here, 14:46, her personal best for 5,000 meters, and that was done in Doha in 2019. And we know that personal best in the 10K of 30:58, she sliced nearly 18 seconds off of her best time. So she could have a lot left here, and she's already jumping out, and there's a gap forming in the field.
It does look like the field is spreading out a little bit. I think there are multiple pacers. I see Emily Lipari doubling back from the 15 and possibly pacing as well. So I'm not sure if there's two paces going on here.
It looks like there might be two packs here. The pack in the back might be going for the Olympic standard of 15:10. And we know that a lot of these women are gunning for that standard here.
Oh, and it looks like Amanda Eccleston just stepped off the track.
So now it's all Ailish McColgan there at the front, charging into the darkness.
Yeah, and Weini Kelati right behind her.
And we've got some numbers here for you. So 15 flat, a number to reference, which is not the Olympic standard. 15:10 is the Olympic standard. But 15 flat is 72-second pace per quarter. And their first quarter here was a 73. Their second was a 71 flat. So they're right on 15 flat pace. And that's Ailish McColgan and Weini Kelati there.
And they're just over a K in, but looking pretty comfortable, I will say, although you definitely want to be feeling comfortable at that point in the race. If you're not feeling comfortable at 1K, it's not a good day.
Is there some self-talk that you would be giving yourself at this point in the race?
I mean, honestly, at this point, I'm trying to, like, not even realize that I'm racing and just go and just kind of zone out and just stay as relaxed as possible, and then start keying in more later in the race.
Another member of this very deep and talented field that we have here is Kim Conley, the New Balance athlete. And she ran 31:40 for 10,000 meters here in the Brickyard 2 weeks ago. And that's coming off of a 5,000-meter run back in December here as well of 15:35. And in the 10,000-meter 2 weeks ago, stay with me here, she ran the same time. She ran 15:35. Through 5K of that race, and then continued on. So we know that she's training very well.
So she's trending in the right direction.
She's trending.
Kim Conley, actually in my first ever track 5K, it was an indoor track 5K, she was in the race, and she ran, I think, 15:08. And I just remember being like so impressed. And then she made the Olympic team that year, so rightfully impressed. She is for real.
Kim Conley first came onto the scene in 2012, where she got that final spot in the 5,000 meters on Team USA, just edging out Julia Lucas. And she's been at the top of the game ever since on a U.S. level. But she's a Northern California woman, grew up in Santa Rosa. She actually went to the same high school as Sarah Hall, and they were teammates there at UC Davis Aggie, too. Let's go Aggies.
Wow. Yeah. You know anything maybe about her parents or pets that she has? Any other information?
I don't know. I think she does have some dogs, yeah.
Okay.
We know that her mom is probably watching, and we would like to say hi.
Shout out.
Shout out to Kim Conley's mom.
You've done well.
You've raised a good woman, and she's going to have a good result tonight. I could feel it in the air. And it looks like Ailish McColgan and Weini Kelati are still out there, and Ailish has taken the brunt of this race here.
Yeah.
She's the one leading out front, and Kelati is just sitting on her heels. The last couple, so we have the third lap that they went through was a 70-second lap, and then a 72-second lap.
Yeah, they're definitely getting after it here, but the chase pack is not really falling far behind. They are still going at a very good pace.
Absolutely. The chase pack seems to still be on or close to the Olympic standard pace. And Emily Lipari is still at the front of that. Right behind Emily Lipari, you have Kellen Taylor. And Kellen Taylor is more of a marathoner. That's their bread and butter. But she also has some great results on the track, too. She ran a 10,000 meter recently, right down here, and I'm finding this information at the moment.
I believe she ran the Olympic standard, right?
Yes, she did. On this track, she ran 31:15 back in December, and then in August, she ran 15:11, actually, just outside the Olympic standard for the 5K.
Okay, yeah.
Kellen Taylor, also widely known as the only marathoner on the planet whom Scott Fobble fears.
I mean, for good reason, right?
She's a tough individual.
I think the last marathon she ran, she PR'd in the half marathon on the way to her marathon finish. So that is a tough way to run a marathon, but man, she grinded it out.
And we see your teammate in there, tucked into the front part of that second pack.
Yeah, looking pretty comfortable, just chilling on the rail. Good position, I'd say.
Yes, and that looks to be, from the front there, a 73-second lap through 2,600 meters.
Nice. Yeah.
So 7:47 through 2,600 meters.
Yeah, I mean, I am interested that not more of the pack went with McColgan. I would kind of expected more of them to aim for that 15-minute pace, but there's still a lot of race left, so they could definitely drop the pace here.
It is a risky move if you're in a pack of two to jump out in the front like that when you know that the sharks are circling behind you in that big pack.
Yeah, it's a very vulnerable position to put yourself in. It takes a lot of confidence in your fitness to take the lead that early.
And McColgan definitely feels confident coming into tonight off of that performance 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
And Kelati looks the same too. I mean, she's got a nice position there on the heels of McColgan.
Yeah. It's nice she's kind of able to just ride that train. Like I said, I'm surprised more people aren't riding it. But yeah, I bet she has some confidence. She had a good second place finish last weekend in the 5K to Eleanor Puryear, who, you know, American record holder in two events. So not the worst person to get second to.
Eleanor Puryear of the New Balance Boston group, and that
and
team is doing great things.
Weini's taking the lead now.
Weini jumping out to the front, and that's off of a 74-second lap, so 9:02 through 3,000 meters for the two of them. And the pace slowed slightly, so Weini jumps to the front, and McColgan now on Weini's heels, and the pack is not too far behind them.
Yeah, McColgan seems to be responding as well, still sticking with her, but we'll see.
And they're floating around here. We'll get you a time as soon as they pass it. But now we could see Emily Sisson at the front of that second pack and then your teammate, Allie Buchalski, too, right behind Sisson. So everybody in that second pack is working together, and they have the benefit of numbers to try and circle through, take the lead a little bit, and reel back this front duo.
They're definitely closing the gap here. Sisson is leading the charge, and Allie is right on her heels. So I'm going to have to say that I think that staying off the lead might have been the right call here, it looks like.
And the pack is coming right in there. Sisson has linked up and is coupled up with McColgan, and now Weini Kelati jumps out to the front, but Sisson and Buchalski are going right around Ailish McColgan.
Yeah, and then right behind them, also coming strong, are Kellen Taylor and Alicia Monson.
Are you going to be able to stay composed here when Allie is starting to make moves
race? Trust me, I'm trying to hold it together, but this is pretty exciting to see. I mean, I'm not surprised. We all knew that this was going to happen. We knew she was going to go off. I mean, I can't say she's gone off yet, but, I mean, look at her. She looks so smooth.
The world is now able to see what has been cooking behind the scenes for so long.
Yeah.
And the last circuit covered in 73 seconds through 3,400 meters, and they're coming up on 3,800 meters shortly.
Almost
And now 4K. The Sisson train keeps rolling with Buchalski on her heels. And they're going by Kelati. And then Ailish McColgan. And then you see Alicia Monson of the On Athletics Club behind her.
Yeah.
And now Sisson at the front, and Kelati has hitched her wagon.
McColgan just stepped off the track.
Oh, and we will get an update to you on what that might have been.
Didn't look like she was hurt or anything. Might have just been an off night, I'm not sure.
All right. But now there's a trio up front. And Emily Sisson, she's got her foot on the gas, and now Buchalski in second, and then Kelati behind her.
Yeah, this is no shade on you, but it is Buchalski, just for clarity.
Thank you, and please throw shade at me when necessary. Allie Buchalski, apologies to all the Buchalskis out there and everyone who loves them.
Yes, which is many people. But Sisson is looking so strong, and I mean, I've seen her in a few track races. I raced a 10K against her once, and she did lap me, so lots of respect for her, and she is just leading this charge right now.
She has put her foot on the gas, and the last two laps have been 70 seconds, and this one coming up, we will get to you shortly. And that is a 69-second lap, so it went 70-70, 69-9. And it looks like Gwen Jorgensen is having a race tonight as well. She was swinging wide, and there you can see her in that second pack, and that's very good to see.
Yeah,
but it's still Sisson.
This is just an exciting race right now. You're right, I'm having a hard time keeping my composure.
So now we're in the final chapter of this 5K, and what are you thinking? What is the goal here?
I did see Allie run a 93-second 600, so I'm going to have to say I'm feeling good about her closing speed.
And it seems like Kelati is trying to hold on to that front duo of Sisson and Buchalski.
Yeah, and I can see Allie's pain face coming out. She's definitely feeling it right now, but she's also just such a racer. Once she's in that atmosphere, she can really pull it out. So I'm excited for her right now in this race that she's having.
And Buchalski, a 15:22 personal best too. So
yeah,
she's en route.
That's going down tonight.
It's all going down tonight here at the Brickyard. And here's the bell. The bell lap with Sisson at the front, and she's stepping on the gas and cranking it down even further. Buchalski and Kelati in tow. And that lap was a 69.8. 69.8 penultimate lap for Sisson.
And going into it, it looks like all three of these ladies have a good chance of breaking 15 if they can close well.
That is a huge mark that you just said there. Something that we haven't seen in American distance running, this kind of depth.
Yeah.
But currently, American distance running is a tough place to be.
Oh yeah, it's very strong right now, and I think you've been seeing that in all of the results lately. So many Olympic standards getting hit, and it looks like we're about to see a few more tonight.
And we have 150 meters to go. They're rounding the curve. You can see the bricks on the inside, and your teammates are yelling at Buchalski to finish, but it's Sisson out in the front, and Sisson charging down the home stretch, and this will be Sisson's day, it looks like.
Yeah.
And we're getting the footage here. You can see the clock in the distance, but Buchalski, I'm sorry, she's holding her off.
Oh, I think she's going to break
and Sisson has got it. 14:55 and then Buchalski 14:57. All three women under 15 minutes in this race.
That's huge. That is huge. I mean, that is a 25-second PR. I mean, come on.
25-second PR for Buchalski. Gwen Jorgensen, 15:08.
So we've got five women under the Olympic standard.
That's five women, ladies and gentlemen. Alicia Monson of Wisconsin, 15:07.
I mean, that was a huge race. I'm sorry. I'm just like, I'm so excited for Allie right now.
What are some words that you want to say to Allie Buchalski over this telecast?
So, I mean, like, I'm not surprised at all. Like, this is exactly what I thought she'd do, and it's just the start. I mean, that's just, she's scratching the surface, and it's only up from here.
And Sisson, a fantastic result for her as well. This group of five. So that is a 15-second personal best for Emily Sisson, who took the win in that race. Many of these women taking personal best tonight.
Yeah, I mean, that was just a fast race overall. I mean, the top eight under 15:20, that used to be under the Olympic standard, you know, 4 years ago. So, I mean, it's just a great showing.
It's a new day. It's a new age in American distance running. And it's crowded at the top, ladies and gentlemen. There are a lot of great teams out there doing great things.